His daughter and his Marines, right?
Johnson roused himself and glanced up. 5 minutes later, the Marines were sitting on the fractured edge of the roadway, feet dangling down into the abyss. Their lav was parked up behind them. Webster was still in the lee of the rock face with McGraw and Johnson, the radio still pressed to his ear. He could hear muffled sounds, like Borkin had pressed his hand over the microphone and was using a walkie-talkie. He could hear his muffled voice alternating with crackly replies. Then he heard the hand come away and the voice come back again, loud and clear in the earpiece.
Okay, Webster. Good work,
Borkin said to him.
Our scouts can see all 8 of them. So can our riflemen. If they move, they die. Who else have you got there with you?
Webster paused. McGraw shook his head urgently. Can't you see? Webster asked. I thought you were watching us.
Not right now,
Borkin said.
I pulled my people back a little, into our defensive positions.
There's nobody else here, Webster said. Just me and the general. There was another pause.
Okay. You two can join the Marines,
Borkin said.
On the bridge. On the end of the line.
Webster waited for a long moment, a blank expression on his face. Then he got up and nodded to Johnson. Johnson got up unsteadily, and the two of them walked forward together around the curve. Left McGraw on his own, crouched in the lee of the rock. McGraw waited there 2 minutes and crawled back south to the Chevrolet. Garber and Johnson's aide were in front, and Milosevic and Brogan were in back. They were all staring at it. What the hell happened? Brogan asked. We're in deep, deep shit, McGraw said. 2 minutes of hurried explanation, and the others agreed with him. So what now? Garber asked. We go get Holly, McGraw said, before he realizes we're bullshitting him. But how? Brogan asked. McGraw glanced at him, glanced at Milosevic. The three of us, he said. End of the day, this is a bureau affair. Call it whatever you want. Terrorism, sedition, kidnapping. It's all FBI territory. We're gonna do it, Milosevic said. Just the three of us? Right now? You got a better way? McGraw said. You want something done properly, you do it yourself, right? Garber was twisted around, scanning along the three faces on the rear seat. So go do it, he said. McGraw nodded and held up his right hand, the thumb and the first two fingers sticking out. I'm the thumb, he said. I go in east of the road. Brogan, you're the first finger. You walk a mile west of the road and go in from there. Milo, you're the second finger. You walk 2 miles west and go north from there. We infiltrate separately, spaced out a mile between each of us. We meet up back on the road a half mile shy of the town. Clear? Brogan made a face. Then he nodded. Milosevic shrugged. Garber glanced at McGraw, and the general's aide started the Chevy and rolled it gently south. He stopped it again after 400 yards where the road came back out of the rock cover, and there was clear access left and right into the countryside. The three FBI men checked their weapons. They each had a government-issued 38 shiny brown leather shoulder holster. Full load of 6, plus another 6 and a speed loader.
Did you like the taste? Didn't like it. Yeah, I'm out.
Milosevic had the longest walk, so he was first to go. He got across the road and struck.